Welcome back to Supreme Science, and in this video, we're going to be talking all about gloves. When you find yourself in a chemistry lab, you're going to want to protect your hands. One of the ways you can do that is with some disposable nitrile or latex gloves. Now, these gloves are great because they protect you against most chemicals you're going to come across in the lab. However, there are a few drawbacks to them. One, because they're disposable, they're actually quite thin, and certain chemicals, especially strong acids and bases, are permeable to them over a short period of time. Particularly, nitrile gloves are also susceptible to ketones like acetone, a common organic solvent. In order to combat that particular disadvantage, you got two options. Option one, grab yourself some butyl gloves that we're fresh out of, or get some thicker, reusable nitrile gloves. There are two additional instances where the simple latex or nitrile glove simply isn't going to offer you the protection that you need in the lab. One is if you're working with particularly abrasive materials, you're going to want to grab yourself some heavy-duty work gloves, and thermal protection. If you're working with liquid nitrogen, CO2, or any cryogenics, not to mention grabbing a beaker off a hot plate or just moving something that's warm, you're going to want to have a pair of thermally insulated gloves. And with all these forms of hand protection at your disposal, there shouldn't be really anything in the lab that you wouldn't be able to handle safely. However, in the instance that you're working with some sort of material that you can't handle directly as a result of its interaction with the atmosphere, perhaps it spontaneously combusts, there is one other option, and that's a glove box. And if you want to check our video on glove boxes, click right here. And it's a good idea to look up as to whether or not your gloves are permeable to certain chemicals that you might be working with. So before you hop in the lab to do your experiment, make sure you take note of all the kind of things that you're going to be encountering throughout the day and get the gloves that you require handy. To make sure that you maintain the dexterity that you require in the lab, grab the pair of gloves that fits you best. In addition to that, if you grab a glove that's too small for you, you might actually decrease its effectiveness, as stretching out the rubber or the nitrile or whatever your glove is made of actually increases the permeability rate of the material. And if you find yourself working with particularly nasty stuff, for added protection, in some circumstances it's advisable to wear one layer of glove on top of the other. This effectively combines the qualities of both gloves. So when you're working in the chem lab, it's important, protect your hands. Grab the set of gloves that protects you best for the equipment and materials you're working with, and happy chemistry. Thanks so much for watching, guys. If you liked the video, hit like down below. And if you're new here, hit subscribe so you don't miss any one of our new videos. And let me know if you've encountered any funny experiences in the lab, perhaps wearing the wrong size glove. Thanks again for watching. I'll catch you guys later.